Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If today is the first time of coming across my beautiful face, you are welcome to my channel. So in my last video, I talked about daughter-in-laws versus mother-in-laws. I talked about wishes that some daughter-in-laws make for their mother-in-laws. I talked about the picture that they have anytime they hear mother-in-law. So if you've not seen that video, I will leave the link in the description box so you go and check it out. This particular video now will be talking about the mother-in-law versus daughter-in-law. Every woman, this video is for you. Please like, share this video. Reason, because you don't know who this video will be of help to. There are many women out there who need to see this video. So I will start by saying that there are many bad mother-in-laws out there. Yes. There are many bad mother-in-laws out there. It's not really that they are bad, but probably they don't like the woman that their son presented to them. Yes, so they will just dislike that woman. Yes, there are some mother-in-laws, there are some mothers that when their son introduces a woman to them, they will just tell their son, no, this woman, this lady or this girl is not coming to this house, and that is it, it's fine. And when their son decides to marry such girl, when their son decides to marry the girl, then the mother-in-law will be a thorn on her flesh. So mother-in-laws, yes, mother-in-laws, why will you be a thorn in the flesh, on the flesh of your daughter-in-law? Now, for your son to choose this woman and say, this is the woman I want to marry, that means he knows what he wants. He knows what he wants. He knows what, because he is the one that is going to live with that woman, not you. You are not going to live with them. So you don't have to dislike any woman that your child, that your son brings home, knowing fully well that you also have daughters, daughters that will one day get married. How will you feel if your daughter calls you and start complaining to you how her mother-in-law treats her? Will you be happy? So don't treat other people's children, daughters, that way. If you value your daughter, that is how the other person values her own daughter. You don't have to value your own child and dislike someone else's child. It doesn't work that way. If you are a mother, you have the love of a mother, then you have to transfer it to every other children out there, especially your children's spouse. You know why? For them to get married to their partner, that means you have become family with them. The woman have given up on her father's name and decided to bear your son's name. Now she is now the member, she's now a member of your household, she's now a member of your family. She is the one to raise a family with your son. You have to support the future of your child. You don't have to rule your child's future because you don't like the particular lady he brought. It's not, there are some mother-in-laws like, the woman did not even do them anything. Once they just say her for the first time, it's finished. They will just say, no, you are not getting married to this woman. Probably because they've already arranged somebody for the son to marry. Madam Arranger. Gone are the days where they arrange children for marriage. Gone are those days when they do that. Now they don't do it anymore. You allow them to make their choice. Even the Bible said that he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing, meaning that he has given the man the power, he has given the man the authority, the privilege to go and look for his own wife. So you don't have to choose wife for your son. And if your son rejects the one you bring for him, you automatically reject the one he has found for himself. Calling the woman all sorts of names like gold digger, you want to come and finish my son's money. There are some mother-in-laws that, hey, Jehovah Nissi. If you cook, if the girl cook, they will say, hey, you've been giving my son only eba. You've been giving him only eba. Or if the woman gave the son spaghetti, hey, no wonder my son is now behaving kwashon. No wonder, because you are giving him only spaghetti, even dummy, what is this? Your son might have changed his choice of favorite food, not before that you are giving him pounded yam, pounded yam, fufu, all those things. Sometimes most of them will just decide to say, okay, I beg, I know fish was swallow again, let me just do normal rice, spaghetti, this English food, because they are watching their weight. Your mother will not understand, dear young man, watching you that is watching your weight. Your mama no will understand that you are watching your weight. Your mother will feel that your wife is starving you. So Biko, for your mother not to torment your wife for starving you, Biko, explain to your mother that you are watching your weight. There are some mother-in-laws that they will, if they don't like you, forget about movie or anything. In reality, there are some mother-in-laws that if they don't like you, they will go to any length to make sure that you leave that family. And mother-in-laws that are on this table, even you that is watching me, you are saying, I am not yet a mother-in-law, but you have a son. And God keep you alive to see your son's spouse. Treat them well. Treat them well. When you love her, she will love your son unconditionally. She will be happy to build a family with your son. Yes. Some mother-in-laws that have this character of barging on their children. Mother-in-laws, please give your son and his wife space. They didn't say you should not come and visit them. Yes, come and visit, but if you are coming, give them the courtesy of telling them that you are coming, because you don't know, they have to prepare for your coming. Yes, don't just barge in on them and start tormenting the wife, especially when it comes to fertility. Oh my God, I discussed it in one of my live video. I discussed about infertility. Many people do not understand that men can also be infertile. And when it comes to mothers, oh my God, they will not believe. They don't even want to hear it. They don't want to accept that their son could be infertile. They always put the blame on the women. So please, mother-in-laws, I would encourage you, if you want a better home for your children, for your son, if you want a better home for your son, you have to be supportive in all areas as a mother. You have to be supportive to your son, to his wife. You have to support them in any way you can. Treat them like, treat your daughter-in-law like your own daughter, because for her to get married to your son, she has automatically become your daughter. There are also mother-in-laws that when it comes to children, hey, hair will be let loose in the house. If the first child is a girl, the second one is a girl, they will start shouting, "Hey, winch, you finish eating all the male children in your womb. Give us a male child. Give us a male child." As if the daughter-in-law has a factory, a company where she produces children, and she has a choice to pick the sex that she wants. Mother-in-laws, people know. Take it easy. There are some mother-in-laws that no matter what the woman does, it's never good in her eyes. Never. If she washes her clothes, hey, problem. If she sweeps, problem. If she cooks, problem. Anything. If she's working, is a problem. If she's not working, problem. So mother-in-laws, please, if you really genuinely love your son, then you should love his wife and treat the wife well. This is all I can say for mother-in-laws. We have lots of things to talk about mother-in-laws. If you watched to this point, don't forget to subscribe. If you've not subscribed, like, share this video, share it to any platform, share it to any group, share it to your Facebook, anywhere, to your friends, share it to anybody, because this video is very, very important to women out there, because we all are praying for change, and the change must start from us. So thank you very much, and bye for now.